हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल जूलॉजी क्लब। दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर अंडर इकोनॉमिक जूलॉजी। आवर चैप्टर नेम इज इकोनॉमिक जूलॉजी लाइफ हिस्ट्री डैमेज एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ पेस्ट। लाइफ हिस्ट्री डैमेज एंड कंट्रोल मेजर्स ऑफ द चाइलो इन्फर्सकैटिलास। दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ सुगर कैन पेस्ट। द क्लास ऑफ चाइलो इन्फर्सकैटिलास इज इंसेक्टा। ऑर्डर इज लेपिडोप्टेरा। फैमिली क्रैम्बिडी। जेनस चाइलो। स्पीसीज इन्फर्सकैटिलास। डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। दिस पेस्ट इज फाउंड थ्रू आउट इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो अफगानिस्तान एंड पाकिस्तान। फूड प्लांट्स। सुगर केन इज द मेन होस्ट ऑफ दिस इंसेक्ट बट इज ऑल्सो फाउंड ऑन बाजरा एंड सम अदर ग्रासेस। जेनरल अपियरेंस। द मॉथ हैज स्ट्रॉ कलर्ड फोर विंग्स एंड हाइंड विंग्स आर वाइट इन कलर विथ एपिकल लाइट एरियस। The moth is about 30 to 40 millimeter in length with wing expanse. Life history. Egg. The female moth lays 10 to 35 eggs in clusters on the lower surface of sugarcane leaves. The eggs are scale-like and creamy white in color. The total number of eggs laid by a single moth is 300 to 400. Larva. After 4 to 5 days of laying, the eggs are hatched into larvae called caterpillars. The caterpillars, with the help of their cutting and chewing type of mouth parts, bore inside the shoot at the base of cane plants. Next, pupa. They feed voraciously and attain full-grown stage in 3 to 4 weeks' time. After full growth, the larvae start the formation of a chamber for pupation and pupate there. Adult. After 5 to 7 days pupation period, the adult moth emerge from the pupae, which come outside through an exit previously prepared by the caterpillars. The lifespan of the moth is about 2 to 4 days. The whole life cycle is completed in 35 to 45 days. 4 to 5 generations have been recorded in a year. Prevention and control of this pest. The shoot attacked by this pest should be removed from the field and destroyed. Moths should be trapped and destroyed. 10% BHC dust mixed with the soil should be sprayed twice during April to June, which can control the pest. This is the picture of the life history of Chilo infuscatilus. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Always try to draw a proper diagram with your answer, which will help you to carry better marks in your exam. For that, you have to practice more and more in drawing. Our second question is, describe the life history, damage and control measures of the Anomys sabulifera. This is the picture of Anomys sabulifera worm and this is the picture of Anomys sabulifera moth. Let's start. The class of Anomys sabulifera is Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Noctuidae, genus Anomys and species is Sabulifera. Distribution. It is distributed in India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Africa and Myanmar. Food plants. It feeds on the apical leaves and buds of jute. Life history. Egg. The female moth lays eggs at the underside of young leaves. One female can lay about 150 eggs and all the eggs are laid singly. Larva. After 2 days of incubation period, eggs are hatched into tiny caterpillars, which start feeding on buds and apical leaves. The caterpillars, after 5 molts during 17 days, attain full grown and this stage it measures about 2 to 4 cm in length. Next, pupa. After completion of larval period, pupa, that means pupation, takes place either on the plant or in the soil. Next, adult. After about 7 days of pupation period in summer, the adult moth emerges out, but in winter it undergoes diapause phase and spends complete winter in pupal stage. The life cycle is completed in about 26 days in summer. A number of generations are completed in about 26 days in summer, but in such case a number of generations are completed in 1 year. Damage. The caterpillar is the destructive stage feeding on the foliage. The half-grown plants are severely attacked here. The second generation may cause 90% damage to the crop under several conditions. The top 10 leaves are commonly damaged, causing retardation in the plant growth. Prevention and control. The infected field should be plowed after harvesting to kill the pupae. By drawing a rope across the young crop, the caterpillar should be displaced. The infected crop should be sprayed with 0.02% endrin and 0.04% methyl parathion. This is the picture of the life cycle and stages of Anomys sabulifera. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Always try to draw proper diagram with your answer, which will help you to carry better marks in your exam. Our third question is, describe the life history, damage and control measures of the paddy pest. This is the picture of paddy pest. Let's start. The class of paddy pest is Insecta, order Hemiptera, family Coridae, genus Leptocorissa, species Varicornis, and another species is Scripophaga incertulus. The class of Scripophaga incertulus is Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Pyraustidae, genus Scripophaga, and species is incertulus. Distribution. The pest is widely distributed in India, UP, Gandhibagh, causes several damage to paddy crop. Food plants. It mainly feeds on paddy but has also been found feeding on bajra, rye, etc. General appearance. This is green or light brown in color and about 20 mm in length. According to its name Gandhi, it emits a strong unpleasant smell. It has long legs for jointed antennae and three jointed tarsi. They are very active in the morning and evening hours. The abdomen of the females is slightly swollen at the top or apex. Life history. It breeds throughout the year and attacks paddy crops in the month of August to October. Egg. The adult females lays about 24 to 30 eggs in rows on the leaves, and each row may have 6 to 20 eggs. The eggs are black, oval or flattened, having concave margins. The eggs or these eggs are fixed on the leaf by the gummy substances secreted by them. It is about 1 mm in length. Nymph. After 6 to 7 days of laying, the egg hatch into young nymphs, which are pale green, long-legged and devoid of wings. Adult. Within 15 to 18 days, young nymphs grow to become adult, and during this process, nymphs pass through 6 stages. The lifespan of the adult bug is of 33 to 35 days. The nymphs and adults are found clustering on paddy crop, although they are not gregarious in nature. The whole life cycle is completed in 4 to 5 weeks. The pest multiplies from July to November, hibernates from December to February, and feeds on grasses from March to June. Prevention and control. Insects should be picked up by hand net and killed by strong crude oil emulsion. In irrigated fields, the crude oil emulsion should be sprayed, which forms thin film of oil, resulting into the killing of bugs and nymphs. Damage. This is a major pest of rice and attacks the paddy field at the milky stage. The nymphs and adults both suck the juice from developing grains in month of August to October, as a result of which the grains cannot be mature. Pest should be attacked by light trap and destroyed. The variety of rice used should be such in which grains come out at a late stage from the sheath. Wild grasses should be removed from the paddy growing areas. 0.25% BHC dust should be sprayed before flowering. The dusting of paddy fields by 2.5% aldrin, 5% chlorine and 5 to 10% BHC has been found to be useful for the control of the pest. दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ द लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ लेप्टोकोराइजा वेरिकॉर्निस. प्लीज टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस पिक्चर. ऑलवेज ट्राई टू ड्रॉ प्रॉपर डायग्राम विद योर आंसर. एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो द लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्क्रिप्टोफेगा इंसर्ट्यूलस. प्लीज टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस पिक्चर ऑल्सो. Now, this is our fourth question. Describe the life history, damage and control measures of the vegetable pest. That means, Leucindis orbonalis. This is the picture of this pest. Class is Insecta. Order Lepidoptera. Family Pyraustidae. Genus Leucinodes and species is Orbonalis. Life cycle. The caterpillars hibernate in winter and pupate in early spring. The adult moths appear in March to April. Egg. The female moth lays 80 to 120 creamy white eggs on the leaves, flower of young fruits. The eggs are laid either singly or in branches of 2 to 4 in each. Caterpillars. After 3 to 6 days of incubation period, eggs are hatched into caterpillars which start boring near the growing point of tender shoots of the host plants, fruits, or into the flower buds. Pupa. The mature caterpillars come out of their feeding tunnel and pupate amongst the fallen leaves, forming boat-shaped cocoons. Adult. The pupal period lasts for about 6 to 17 days, after which adult moth emerges out. The whole life cycle is completed in 20 to 43 days during active season. Four overlapping generations have been recorded in 1 year. The lifespan of moth is of 2 to 5 days only. Single caterpillar can destroy 6 fruits. After 9 to 28 days, the caterpillars become full grown, passing through 5 stages of different instars. Prevention and control. The affected fruits and drooping shoots containing caterpillars inside should be collected and destroyed. The spraying of pesticides can control the pest population in the field. This is the picture of this pest and this is the picture of the life history of this pest. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Now our fifth question is, describe the life history, damage and control measures of the Bandicoota bengalensis, that is rodent pest. This is the picture of Bandicoota bengalensis or rodent pest. Vertebrate pest. The scientific name of this vertebrate pest is Bandicoota bengalensis, or it is also known as Indian mole rat. Characteristics of this pest. The species are commonly inhabits the fields of crop vegetables and fruits. It is a fearless animal and grunts when in anger. This is very good swimmer. The dorsal surface of the rat is covered with thick harsh fur of grayish brown color and grayish white on the ventral surface. Tail is sometimes shorter but sometimes as long, long long as the body. The number of young ones per litter varies from 15 to 60 per litter. The burrows are generally shallower and have more than one opening. They stock the food grains inside their burrows for future feeding when food would not be available easily. Habit and habitat. Rats are well adapted to adjust themselves everywhere because they are provided with highly developed sense of smell, hearing and touch. Thus, they keep themselves away from any type of danger. They always go on their runway and remain careful and alert for any new object which they come across. They identify their routes with the help of dark aggressive mark left in their way. In the night, the rat usually come out of their burrows and actively keep themselves busy in feeding and in storage of food. At the time of this activity, rats never get disturbed by any sound, but as soon as if someone reaches there, they become alert. The home range of the males is greater than the female and varies from 50 to 100 feet from their burrows. Formation of burrows. Before the formation of burrows, the rats survey the field for the position of crop and humidity in the soil. The house rats dig their burrows in well-sheltered places near to the storehouse of grain. Where is field rats form their burrows in the middle area of density growing crops. They make more than one opening in the burrows and chambers visible: breeding chamber, storage chamber in field burrows with a depth of 0.3 to 1.5 meter and diameter 0.03 to 0.685 meter. The length of the burrows is up to 40 meters with variations in the shape, size and depth pattern according to the nature of rat species. The amount of food grains collected from a single burrow of Bandicoota species was 0.035 to 5.94 kg, highest to all other species. Thus, the main aim of the burrow formation is protection, favorable microclimates, storage of food, breeding facilities. After observing a large number of burrows, it was found that six types of burrowing patterns exist. First one is blind short with single opening. Second one is blind long with single opening. Third one is blind ramified with single opening, U type. And the next is ramified and the next is intercommunicable. The burrow's fauna and flora consists of earthworm, ants, beetles, mites, etc. This is the picture of rat's burrow. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Now, movement of rats. Generally, movement of rats occurs just after harvesting of crops. In unfavorable climatic conditions due to shortage of food material in a particular area and other factors cause the migration of rats from one store to other and from one field to other. Generally, in the month of July to August, when fresh food materials are abundant in the field, rats come out of their burrow in search of suitable food grains in the night and damage paddy crops. The average distance traveled by grass rat was found to be 75.61 meters in 20 minutes. The maximum distance recorded at the time of migration is 551.0 meters in the field. It has also been observed that rats are very good swimmers. The distance covered by swimming in 5 minutes has been recorded to be 16 to 19 meters in case of mole rat. The antelope's rats are very far swimmers. It is far, F-A-R, very far swimmers, but they were found climbing on trees and walls and can make horizontal jump of 8 feet. This is the picture of the burrow of rats. Please take a screenshot of this picture. Damage caused by rodent pest. The nature of damage by the rodent or rat is variable from species to species and crop to crop. In wheat crop, the maximum damage was recorded at the ripening stage. The loss calculated per hectare in the yield is about 52 kg in the field in Punjab. Due to the alternative cropping scheme, the damage by rats per crop can be reduced easily. The damage of sugarcane crop due to rats in the field is much least in early stages but also in latter stages, that from October, sugarcane are attacked by much by rats. In coconut fruits, one or two holes are made by the rats near the stack and they damage the carpal of the coconut. From the data available, it is estimated that rat destroys 11.5% wheat, 5.8% barley in the field. They destroy 4.6% to 5.4% paddy, 4.1% to 25.8% groundnut, 1.4% maize, 2.2% sugarcane and 5% coconut. It is interesting to note that the rats feed activity in 5 to 10 meter radius, that is meter, 5 to 10 meter radius around their burrow. The amount of damage caused by rat is very much proportionate to the population of rats and their species in that locality. The burrows made by rats weakened the foundation of buildings, caused damage in several cases. Diseases spreads by rats. Apart from damaging grains, fruits, vegetables, etc., rats spread a number of diseases among human beings and their pets of common use. 32 diseases of man and other animals are known to be transmitted by rats. They are reported to carry 18 different kinds of ticks, fleas, and mites. Different types of viruses, bacteria, fungi, protozoa, nematodes, arthropods cause several diseases. Such type of diseases spread by rodent pests are bubonic plague, typhoid fever, rat bite fever, food poisoning, jaundice, etc. Rattus, Bandicoota bengalensis, Tetra indica are carriers of bubonic plague. Methods of rat control. Rat control is an important and complicated program in which a number of control devices have been developed as a result of practical experiences and scientific researches. Methods of rat control. First method is ultrasonic wave. Ultrasonic waves are very much powerful killers of rats without any damage of human beings. Next, traps. Traps are used in modified form in different localities and with the species of rat to be controlled. Sometimes this method is practiced in house to catch the house rats. The useful and common traps are bamboo bow and arrow trap, and the second is pot trap. So, bamboo bow and arrow trap is, it comprises of triangular bamboo sticks fixed on burrows or tracks of rat. As rats get into it to take the food, the bamboo sticks snap automatically, trap and kill the rats. Next is pot trap. It is around earthen pot of 20 cm diameter and 17 cm height, containing a lid and good pegs of 30 cm. The lid is adjusted in such a way on the ground that the pot falls on the lid when disturbed. The bite is placed on the lid and also inside the pot. The bite, when disturbed, falls on the lid and rat is trapped. Next, biological control. The natural enemies like cats, snakes, and a number of birds are predators of rats in the houses and the fields. Cats are very common in houses and also go to the neighboring fields in search of their prey and catch the rats very actively. Some birds like hawk, owl, and cats are active predators of rats in the field. It is surprising that rats are eaten by human beings also. Chemical control. Chemicals of various nature are applied with different modes of action affecting the rat population. They are generally being used in the form of fumigants, attractants, and rodenticides. The most effective fumigants are calcium cyanide, calcium monoxide, and carbon dioxide. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and like this video and share this video with your friends. Thank you.